epic. Giants. Land of the giants out here.
Big. Be a trout, baby. Be a trout, baby. Wow, wow, wow. Giant. Giant something. Oh, monster trout. Monster trout, yes. Woohoo! What a staving brookie that is. What a staving giant brook trout. Ho! Dude!
That's 5 pounds.
Yeah, right to the rubber band.
Oh my god.
Dude!
Nice!
Look at the size of that trout.
That is a pretty fish, you get it?
It's right there.
Wow.
Look at that! Look at that staving trout. Oh my god.
That's smoking it when you got here?
It was to the band.
Oh really?
Yeah.
Dude, that's a pretty fish.
That's the biggest trout I think I've caught.
Yeah. Yeah. There you go.
That look good?
Yeah, that's pretty.
That's what you were hooting and hollering about.
Dude.
All right, I'm going to let him go. All right, let's let him go. Guys, we're going to recycle that smile. Look at the size of that trout. All right, we're going to let him go. There he goes.
Dude.
That was awesome.
That was a good one.
I got the hollering about something over there.
Yeah, well, he was, I just missed him. When we all pulled away, the flag went up and it chewed my worm.
Yeah.
So I reset it, same worm, and I watched it go off and I came right over and it was already to my band. And I was like, oh my God, that's a big head shake. I'm like, I hope this is a trout. And sure as heck, it was a trout. Oh, there we go.
Yeah.
Did I let it hit the band, you think?
I don't know. That's up to you. Get him on the run. That's up to you.
Little guy. Wicked little head shakes. Oh, my God.
Trout, though?
Yeah. Nice. Tiny. Maybe not. Yep. There's an eater.
Yeah. Get it.
Oh, it's right there. There. Nice one, guys. Let's get him back.
Set yourself.
Saver. See it?
Big worm.
Ah, huh? Oh, trout. Rookie. Another one. About the same size, but a lot smaller. It's a 6 pounder, but yeah, I feel bad for the guy.
He ain't gonna do it. He'll do it.
Take it. It's to the band. Take it. Take it, Bob. I can't do any better than I've done. It's right to the band.
It don't feel right.
It's all right.
Feel like.
A lot of things don't feel right. Oh, maybe it wasn't to the band, sorry.
Should
Should we wait for it to hit the fan?
I don't know. Chubbs always says take it while she's running.
I always take him on the run.
I do too.
You can't let him get wrapped around something.
Good?
No.
Fish?
Fish.
All right.
Very
good. Nice. Little brook trout. Take it on a run, baby.
Got it.
Get that worm. Oh,
thank gosh. I'm a big fan of taking him on the run. Oh, what a pretty fish. Look at the back. I love those markings. Nice.
Not bad. Job, Chibs.
All right.
Little guy going back.
See you later.
Recycling smiles.
He wants to stay.
Customer?
Yeah, I think we're at the band. Want him?
No.
All right. Should I let Sean get him?
It's up to you.
Little guy. This is the little, this one's tiny. Smallest one ever. Oh, no. You want them?
Wow.
First one of them in a little while.
Is that a shiner?
No, it's Chubb.
What?
Chubb.
Oh, yeah.
You thought you had red fin.
That's like perfect size.
I'm gonna go put that on the bait.
It's gonna be hard leaving this lake tomorrow. I'm not gonna lie.
Game on.
Little guy. Head shaking though, but real small. Oh, we're Sean's bucket.
No.
You got a bucket? You got your bucket?
You know what? See how you are, using all my worms, saving yours.
Well, I'm gonna need something later in the day.
Here you go.
I appreciate you.
Uh-huh.
For who you are as a person.
Yep.
Freaking worms.
You're kidding.
I kid you not. We might have a chub hole here, fellas. Yep. Jig rod time.
Going around in a circle.
You want it?
No.
It's gonna be big.
Potential.
Oh yeah, it's big.
Good one.
It's got some weight, but no head shakes.
Doesn't know it's caught yet.
Now we got head shakes.
Oh, yeah.
Rookie number four.
Give us that worm back.
I know. Oh, he cut my worm. Yeah, you're good with it. All right, guys, there's a little brookie, probably, a little bit over 12 inch, probably. But beautiful, beautiful fish. I don't know if you guys can see those worm markings on its back. Looks like my camera's fogged up.
Bye-bye.
Got him, he's tiny. Tiny, tiny. Oh, a little brookie, a little baby brookie. Number five for the day, guys. All right, little brookie there. You get him back, let him grow. Catch him when he's bigger.
It's finger food.
Nice. Did you eat some, Chubbs?
I have not yet. I'm gonna get right into it though.
Might be nap time after eating some of this.
We're gonna take the egg. A couple of these little guys right here.
You building a sandwich?
Actually three. So we're gonna go for a three banger.
Wow.
Yep. I can't do it. I don't know what to do with my hands once the camera turns on.
Just do this, and you move them and point like while you're talking. What is up, guys? Joe Holland here. We are here on the world-famous Moosehead Lake in northern Maine? Central Maine? What would you call it?
I call it northern Maine.
It's called northern Maine, but I think if you looked at the map, it's like about center.
Yep.
Maybe a little bit more. Fishing today with good buddies, Chubbs and Sean. And we're fishing for the native Maine brook trout. We're trying to catch a big brook trout or a lot of them. That's what Chubbs and I are doing. Sean, on the other hand, is still after the state record chub. The state record mountain trout. He just missed it last year. If you guys missed that video, I'll put it up here in the cards. But yeah, he caught a staving chub. He's got 4 or 5 this trip on the ice. So go back a couple episodes too if you haven't seen those. We're having like our best brook trout trip we've ever had on native Maine brookies. I think we have 5 over 20 inches so far. So 5 big stavers and 13 total. Yesterday we braved it out and we had a rough day in 30 to 50 mile an hour winds. We were the only guys on the lake.
Yeah, crazy wind.
Seems like a common theme. But we hit like 15 lake trout and or 14 lake trout and a salmon. So awesome day there. If you want to check that out, check us out, Deep Water Fishing. We decided to take the day off from the brookies. But today we're fishing an area that I've always wanted to fish. And we're just kind of letting the wind dictate where we fish this week. We have a hit list of places we want to fish. You know, Cowan's Cove, Little Duck, Big Duck, the edge of Lily Bay, Donut Cove, Sugar Island. Areas that are still open to ice fishing, because there's a lot of certain specific areas that are closed in front of anywhere that the brook trout could be winter or fall or winter spawning. I guess they've got it closed off. But the brook trout fishing here on Moosehead Lake is top notch. Guys are catching 4 to 7 pounders every year. Ever since the smallmouth got a hold in this lake, you know, that invasive species, the brook trout fishing has really come to the front and gotten way better and better every year. So there's a lot to be said for that. You know, I don't know the reasons why. It could be that the smallmouth are eating one of the brook trout's predator. It could be that the smallmouth are being eaten by the brook trout. But you can't argue the facts, is once they're in here, the brook trout fishing has gotten better and better. So we're mostly fishing worms and smelts. We're fishing super shallow water. I'm going to probably go through at least one set of blades today, maybe two, and we'll see how we do. Stay tuned.
Well,
be tiny. He wasn't even hooked.
Was that a brookie?
Yeah, it was a brookie. But he wasn't hooked and he jumped up, hit the bank, and went back down. Like a 10 inch.
He was just holding that worm in his mouth?
No, he let it go and he still came up.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Chasing it.
Yep.
Crazy how freaking you got a jig down there and they're still going for the worm.
Right? Easy tag it.
Where are these things coming from that they're swimming by all of our traps to get over here?
Customer?
Oh.
How come you didn't let me take that?
Little guy. You don't want little guy. Little cookie brookie. There's your male. Nope. I mean, there's your female.
Kind of looks like your female, yeah.
Nice little brookie. Chubbs, I'm going for the Chubbs release.
Yeah, there you go.
Let me beat him one more time.
What's that, brookie number 6?
6 brookies today. One more and we tie our record.
Yeah, but at least those were caught.
Which we keep hearing about.
Those were caught between us. This is all you.
Not looking good, fellas. Now it's looking good, fellas. Tiny, tiny, tiny. Feels like a chubba. Oh, whoa, whoa, whoa. Number.
That one's got some nice looking spots on it.
What number are we at?
I think you got 6 now.
7?
six or seven, yeah.
Well, we're just going to stay at six the rest of the day.
What's the most we've caught as a group in a day? Seven, right?
Yeah, we can't have you beat that, so no matter how many more you catch, you still caught six.
That one swallowed it.
Deep in it. Ow. Ow.
All right,
guys. Another brookie going down. Smash fest continues. They're getting smaller.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
It's a tree.
Oh, no.
Didn't get any water.
What do you loan your buddy? What do you loan your buddy your auger?
No fish there.
Oh man. Smoke them.
Done for.
Ouch. There you go, Sean. Chubadoo. Nice little mountain trout there, guys. Non-spotted mountain trout, they call those.
Were those ones you caught, Chamberlain, like that?
Yeah. Oh, yeah, so there was a rookie game warden. They do like a probationary period. I think it's like 2 or 3 months. They gotta do like ride along with seasoned game wardens.
Right.
And the seasoned guy, it was during like bird season up in the North Maine woods where they're trying to catch people riding around with loaded guns and shooting birds from the vehicle rather than just get out and shoot it. It's a big thing. People like shooting birds out of the truck, I guess. So in order to catch them before they'd unload, because a lot of them guys are riding around with a single shot opened up but loaded, you know, so all they got to do is close it. So when a warden comes, they see the warden or another truck coming, they just reach down and pop that shell out, or two shells if it's a double barrel. So in order to catch him, the older warden had a really good trick where he'd leave like a chain or an axe in the road, you know, making it look like it fell off a truck. And those guys would be riding along looking for birds and they'd see that chain or axe or whatever, and they would back up and open their door to reach down to get it. When they did, he'd run out of the bushes. Main game wardens! Hands up, you know, then he'd look and the guy didn't have time to unload his gun, so he'd get him every time. So he taught that young warden that. And then that young warden got in a district where there was a guy that was notorious for doing it that he could never catch. So he said, I'm going to try that trick. So where's my thermos? He had a brand new thermos that his family gave him, one of these for passing the warden exam.
Right.
And he took his thermos. And he knew the guy was in the area, and he set it right in the road. And the guy drove by, saw the thermos. The taillights come on. The young warden's all excited. He's like, oh, we're going to get him. You know, he's hiding in the bushes, waiting for him to back out, jump out, and see if his gun's loaded. And that guy puts it in reverse and backs right over that thermos at full speed, then drives off and never stopped. So I guess the guy that was cagier was the guy who'd been doing it a lot longer on the wrong side of the law. She fetched up.
Until you took me down into the pucker brush. See, that is some really, really tiny.
Set on it.
It's very set tiny.
On. All right,
Chubb,
you got a brookie.
Cute little guy.
I didn't know they made them this small.
Oh, they do. I know all about them.
I can get that hook.
Yeah. See you later, dude.
Yeah, I am finally on the board.
There's a lot of brook trout in this little cove.
Only took till noontime, but I am on the fish. I am on the meat.
Is it about to happen?
It's happening, fella. How long can they hold their breath? That was cool, guys. We were over there fishing, and we looked over, and an otter poked his head out of that hole and went back under. He's mowing brook trout. Pretty cool.
I need another pole.
Back out of it. Hey, back out of it.
No.
Oh, that was close. Close. Back out of her.
Some scallops and some bacon.
And you ever wrap bacon in scallops?
No, I have never done that. Don't mind my fingers.
Doesn't work so well. The piece wasn't big enough.
Only big enough.
There's small bacon kicking around somewhere too.
Yeah.
Bacon hors d'oeuvres.
Hors d'oeuvres.
Blackstone. This is I think 22 inch. Blackstone, flat top. It's a jack of all trades. If you gotta cook it, it'll do it, basically. Everything you cook on it is very fat. Nothing healthy about it.
True.
Use lots of butter, lots of oil, lots of bacon grease.
I heard stories about lots of hot dogs on this trip, but I ain't eaten the one yet.
I know. Yeah. I was thinking about that this morning. I said, what if we gotta throw some hot dogs in? But we got two. Apparently everybody was thinking about scallops on the way up, so.
Yeah, we got two bags of scallops, tenderloin, tenderloin.
I mean, overall, we have way too much food.
Yeah.
Wow.
What do you think?
Pretty excellent. Might be the best thing I've ever eaten off this Blackstone.
Definitely the best thing from the trip so far.
I'm making the other pack when we get back.
You got more steak bombs.
Why don't we do it now?
Because we're going to go catch a big first.
Oh, when we get back from there.
Yeah.
I thought you meant
back to camp.
Yeah, me too.
What are we waiting for?
Well, guys, I don't know if you can beat bacon-wrapped scallops on the ice off the Blackstone while we're catching brookies. We got one high flyer over there. Good thing I got the band on it, so it'll be on the leash by the time I get there. Ah, it's hot.
Too hot. But we're suffering through it, you know? It's a hard life.
Like grassy bottom.
What's up, guys? Chris Dolan here. We are on the world famous Moosehead Lake. I'm sitting here not catching any fish because Joe Holland is the premier fisherman out here showing us how it's done. I mean, it's crazy. He could put a trap in a mud puddle and catch a monster brookie out of it. At this point, I think that would be true. I mean,
but we are eating scallops wrapped in bacon.
We're enjoying our time. It has been fun. We've caught a lot of fish this trip.
Way more than last year's trip. Way more.
The guy that makes the traps has not done very well. You probably won't see him much in this video other than eating.
You might be surprised, actually. You might be surprised.
He made a nice smudge yesterday. Had a nice fire going yesterday.
You know, I'm just making content.
Right. We're here to build content.
We should just hire you as the video guy.
Yeah. We need a videographer. Somebody to edit the videos, make things happen.
I told you I'd make good cameraman.
You're right.
He knows how to build a phenomenal trap. He just doesn't know how to use it. It's that stupid red line you got on them traps. I hate that. I would go right out to every one of your traps right now and kick them right down the hole. And I'd go buy new ones and put some nice white line on. It's a nice orange line, lime green.
Anything
other than that, red or blue or black.
The fish are scared of it.
This snow is deep in here.
Looks like you need a pole. You're overheating.
Huh? It's just right in the middle.
There you go. You're moving. Were you stuck a while?
As soon as you went up.
Want me back down the trail? Want me pack it down?
I'm done again.
Stuck again?
I think so.
You should get a snowmobile.
I know.
Tell you? Hook up that strap.
Probably the easiest way.
Yeah. We'll get you out of here. Daddy's here.
Thanks, Joe. Come back.
The battery's almost dead.
Oh, wait, what's this doing?
Probably next to the hitch. See the hooks?
You don't think it'll bend on it? One of these days I'm gonna learn.
This thing tows pretty good.
I don't belong in 4 feet of snow.
Nah, you'll get a snowmobile someday. If your wife lets you.
Yeah, Crystal.
Come on, Crystal. See what you're putting them through?
Got him.
Nice little trout. All right.
beautiful little guy. I was resetting this one. I got a bite as I was setting it. That's a mountain trout. Nice one. Chubbs, give the folks at home, let them know what a moose sounds like. Give them a good moose mating call. That's pretty good. Keep going.
Works pretty good.
Do the cow.
Huh?
Do a cow. Did it work?
Ah!
Got me a flag.
Whoa. 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 Whoa.
Doing?
Oh, my flag's up way over there.
Well, this isn't about you right now. This is about Sean. So, join the team.
Oh, the line's wrapped around the peg.
No, it isn't either.
Is it?
Oh, yeah.
Might have snapped him. Catch it.
Oh, boy. Oh!
Look at that thing.
Oh my god. Dude, look at the size of this. Look at the size of this giant. He never set the hook. I was like, is he using a smelt? Because I could see the thing just doing this. You gotta hold that up for the camera. Like I said, the guy who catches the least usually catches the biggest one.
That's my biggest hook too. It's a big friggin' hook.
Holy gosh.
Hold the fish.
I'm trying.
They must have held on to.
Epic. Giants. Land of the giants out here.
Oh. Show the folks at home.
You almost lost him. All right, buddy. I'll hold it really close.
On the board.
Good for you.
The time, every time.
Just barely tripped.
Yeah, it's going right straight down. Nothing.
Goshy.
Look at that.
Tripping?
Took quite a few.
Need a worm?
Got him.
Oh, what is it? What is it? Yellow perch? Little yellow perch.
Chris Dolan here. We have had an epic Moosehead week. We have caught multiple slamming brookies, had a huge togue day, one salmon. Joe Holland has showed me how to fish, for sure. Every time I got a big one, he got one even bigger. Had to. Yesterday's weather sucked. Today was beautiful. We got wind picking up now. It's getting pretty dark, so we're gonna call it a trip. I think these guys are gonna fish one more day. I gotta leave tomorrow, gotta work, you know, fun stuff. But we've had an epic trip. I mean, you couldn't ask for a better time. You couldn't catch bigger fish. We've had a great fishing trip, except for Sean. Sean's caught some really, really nice panfish. You know what I mean? Pan fryers.
Just wait till tomorrow.
But Yeah.
I still got time. You're leaving.
I'm leaving.
All right, guys, so that's your recap for the day. We're going to film a little bit more. We'll show you dinner. We might head over to the Rockwood Bar and Grill and see what's happening over there. We might not, but we're going to eat some good grub tonight. And we still got about a 9-mile ride to get off the lake. And, yeah, that's it. We're watching the premiere from Tuzunka right there.
It's pretty bad, even on the snowmobile. It's better with the snowshoes, but it ain't much better. As you can see, I broke through a little.
Yeah, that was getting off the lake. So I get to watch that on the ride home. And I think the boys are going to try to watch theirs, too.
If we don't have enough rope, Johnny's going to run back. My snowmobile's still...
Guys, Joe Holland here.
Oh, you gotta shoot the outro for tonight. We'll do it after dinner.
We probably ought to do it now.
Alright, you're on. Go.
What?
Go.
You go what?
You're on.
Where? Where am I going?
You're on.
I'm all on.
The outro. So
what's up, guys?
Huh? Alright, what's up, guys? Joe Holland, Sean Norton. Chris Dolan here, back at camp, we're doing a recook, we had a beef stew last night, we did not eat all of it.
We got some cheesy bread.
Joe Holland here caught way more fish than the rest of us.
Actually, all the fish today.
No. We caught a couple of brookies, there was two of us.
I caught one little tiny one.
Yeah, I caught one little tiny one.
Joe showed up. First thing, drilled a hole.
Punched one hole.
Guys, I got
you could drill a hole in a mud puddle.
He's got... Fuck.
You would catch a fish. So we're here back at camp. We're chilling out. We're going to have some dinner.
That looks tall.
These guys, I got a fish. Moosehead again. What, one more day?
Maybe we'll see how
one more day.
We'll see what the day brings.
I gotta go home tomorrow.
You know, for us, we can do whatever we want. We can fish another 12 days. We can fish one more day.
I gotta go home tomorrow.
Chubbs has to leave. He's got a real life.
Real life has got to hit me at some point. But we have had a epic week of brook trout fishing. There's nothing better.
Off-roading with the fork.
Oh, yeah. We got some good off-road footage.
That was the best brook trout fishing I've ever seen in my life.
Oh, yeah.
Every single flag felt like it could have been 6 pounds.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
We had some epic brook trout fishing. Moosehead Lake is one of the premier lakes in the state of Maine to catch brook trout.
Ever since the small homies got in here.
I don't understand it.
It's crazy.
Yeah, it's crazy, but yeah.
What is up, guys? I'm Chubbs. I had a fish in the air.
What's up, guys? I'm Joe Holland, dude.
Who's this?
This is Smoke Show Sean Norton.
Can't catch a clap.
No. We're up here in Moosehead Lake.
Smash the brookies.